those things. As a man thinks, so yes, you are what you think.
Put your hands together for my man. All right. Great. All right, the pulpit. All right, hold on. Marvin, you seem to have a lot of confidence. What should we expect from you tonight?
I'll kill the police, thank you.
Okay. With smiles on your faces, would you please put your hands together? Help me welcome to the pulpit, Marvin!
Praise the living God. Hallelujah. Shall we pray? Our Lord Jesus, cause us to abide in your word. Amen. My text is taken from Romans chapter 5, verses 6 to 11. But I'll be reading only verse 6. And I read, you see, at just the right time, when we were still powerless, Christ died for the ungodly. Amen. The theme for my message is the salvation of God. The Children's Ministry Resource Bible explains salvation as God's free gift of eternal life, for which one may have by believing that the Lord Jesus Christ died and rose again for mankind. Paul writes to the church in Rome, presenting the gospel of Jesus Christ, which is the salvation plan for all. He begins the epistle with the righteousness of God and his wrath against mankind for their sins. He speaks of God's faithfulness and shows man the way of salvation. In chapter 5, verse 1 to 5, Paul tells his audience that they have been justified by faith, and through the Lord Jesus Christ, they had gained access into his grace. Praise God. In verse 6 to 11, he throws further light on the salvation plan of God and what it means for man to be saved. Let's go to the passage to consider two things about salvation. Firstly, God's salvation plan targets even the worst sinner or the ungodly. In verse 7 and 8, Paul tells his audience that it is very uncommon for a man to die, even for a righteous man. But whilst they were yet sinners, Christ died for them. Praise God. The salvation Christ brings is for everyone, even for the worst sinner. Some of us believe that our sins are too many and great, and therefore we don't qualify for God's forgiveness and salvation. Whatever sin you have committed, you can be forgiven. Christ died for all your sins, and he loves you. Nobody cleans himself before going to the bathroom, so come as you are. Accept Jesus Christ because he died for you even when you were sinners. Secondly, salvation removes you from God's punishment and connects us back to God. I mean reconciliation. In verses 9 and 11, in these verses, Paul tells his audience that the blood of Jesus had declared us or made us righteous in the sight of God, and therefore were no more enemies of God. Paul talks of the judgment and punishment in chapter 2, where he says evil people will get distressed and destruction. He refers to it here and says that because of Jesus Christ, we will escape his punishment. Praise God. God's punishment is very harsh and harsher than the hardship we are going through. And I tell you, you cannot bear it. If one government wants to punish you,
You can run to another country. But if the creator of the heavens and earth is punishing you, where will you go or run to? Accept Jesus Christ and you'll be connected to God and escape his punishment. In conclusion, I encourage you to accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and personal Savior. For one, he died for you even when you were a sinner. Two, his salvation would help you escape God's punishment. God richly bless you. Amen.
Amen. God richly bless you too.